thank you for being here. This event has been a while coming, and I'd like to tell you a little bit about how we got to where we're at now. So I have played trombone in the Art Abram Swing Machine Big Band for quite a few years. And about 10 years ago, Art was saying, "David, we need to form a new band that plays Elvis music." And I thought, yeah, the world needs another Elvis impersonator. Yeah. And so I kept trying to put him off. And then about 5 years ago, he just twisted my arm enough, so okay, I did it. And I wrote, you find my name in the program a little bit here. And I said, okay, I'll do this. So Art chose all the musicians, and it's not exactly the same as the big band. It's about half of the big band. And he chose the music, and he sent me recordings, and I made all the arrangements and stuff. And I told him that if we're going to do this, we need to have a vocalist, but we're not doing Elvis impersonator stuff. So let's first of all get female vocalists. And second of all, let's find people that are really skilled in the rhythm and blues gospel kind of world, which is the world that Elvis did come from. So that's how we got to where we're at right now. And before I bring out LaRonda, I want you to know that, you know, when you go to the symphony and you're super quiet and nobody says a word because you might interrupt the violin players or something. And then when it's over, people do this. This is not the symphony. If you like something, shout about it. She's been super fun to work with. She's a real professional. She does a lot of work here at the Abbey. So please welcome LaRonda Steele.
Yeah, but wait, look at that. So we're just trying to, you know, stay with the same groove. You see those shoes, y'all? Yes. All right. Okay. Thank you for being here. Great. Yes.
One, two, one, two. Baby, let me be teddy bear. Put a boa around my neck. Lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. I don't wanna be a tiger, 'cause tigers play too rough. I don't wanna be a lion, 'cause lions ain't the kind you love enough. Just let me be your teddy bear. Just put a boa around my neck and lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. Baby, let me be around you every night. Run your fingers through my hair. Cuddle me real tight. Let me be your teddy bear, yeah. teddy bear. Put a boa around my neck, lead me anywhere, oh, let me be your teddy bear. Teddy bear, your teddy bear. Oh, oh, love it. Your teddy bear.
So, fun fact about the first known teddy bear was 1901. Oh, well, I mean, that is a fun fact, right? So, when asked to do Elvis songs by Art and Dave, I was kind of like, really? Leeds? Elvis tunes? But it's really kind of fun. Roundabout. See, all you scholars out there, you know. So I don't even want to say dates. I'm just going to say the name of the song is Don't Be Cruel to a Heart That's True.
You know I can be found sitting all alone. If you don't please, please telephone. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Baby, if I made you mad with something I might have said, please let's forget the past. The future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true.
wonderful. What an incredible band, y'all. I am just tickled. Purple, blue, green, red, orange, and red about being here with this wonderful band. So grateful for this opportunity. Thank you. Yeah, I know that's right. Yes. So it's a lovely song. So we dedicate this to this wonderful couple. Yes.
Is to be clear.
Thank you so much.
It's almost Christmas, isn't it?
Why does he want to play a chart?
I just thought we should do this tune. And John Onstead, I've known since he was in high school, and his high school band director over here, Rick Tippetts. And yeah.
He's my Mr. Holland.
John has become just the number one bass trombone player in this city, and everybody loves him and everybody wants him in their band. And he's got this instrument that is the biggest trombone that the world has ever known. So here is John Onstead singing and playing trombone on Blue Christmas. Thank you. By the way, my wife bought me these blue suede shoes. Have you noticed? She's terrific. Her name is Amy Lesage. Come on out here, Amy.
Let's do it. Oh, this is gonna be Love Me Tender. Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Love me dreams fulfilled. For my darling, I love you, and I always will.
This next one, I want to bring back out the fabulous LaRonda Steele to have a little fun with me before intermission. Our next song was written in 1962 for the movie Girls, 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 starring Elvis Presley. Oh, I got a slider. It's a song about a lover who just ain't writing back.
Oh, my.
I know. I think if it were written these days, it might be called something like Left on Red or Ghosted.
Yeah.
You know, technology has changed, but I think the feelings are the same.
The feelings are much the same. All right. Tell us the story.
Return to sender.
I wrote a letter to the post. I put it in his sack. Bright and early next morning, he brought my letter back. She wrote upon it, return to sender, address unknown, no such number, no such zone. We had a quarrel, a lover's fight. I dropped it in the mailbox. I said it's special day.
Okay. Yeah.
Bright and early next morning, it came right back to me. She wrote upon it.
Amy LeSage.
LaRonda Steele.
All right. So now you all, we're going to take a short intermission so that you can go back and buy up all the CDs and find out other ways you can support this wonderful nonprofit called the Alberta Abbey, y'all. Alberta Abbey's got it going on, right? Yeah. Wonderful music here. So we'll be back in. In 13 minutes. 13 minutes, all right, y'all. Bless you. We'll be back.
So then, and then we said, well, you know, Art is 92 years old, and we should honor him as well. So we should get this band off the ground, and so Rick and I have done most of the legwork to get this to where we are right now. And Rick has a few things to say. My good friend Rick Tippett.
We need to get Art up here. There he is. My friend, I was asked to do this because I am the original trombone player that's still in this band, the Swing Machine Band. I joined the band 36 years ago. Yep. And I remember our first gig, it was at an Elks Club. We had enough music to play two sets for a three-set gig. And so the third set, we had repeat music. Embarrassing. All right, now, with the investment you've put into getting original arrangements and years of organizing the band, and for this gig and the other, it's almost 700 pieces of music in the book. Yeah. And we've had a long history together. This band has opened for and accompanied some name artists. So I'm gonna read off a few names here, if you don't mind. Okay. So, I'm going to start with Dave Brubeck. Pretty cool. Yeah. I'm going to have to put my glasses on.
Good.
Well, all right. So, okay. Yeah, we were pretty busy back then. We played a lot of summer concert series in the park and dances and so on. But, you know, like the Mount Hood Festival of Jazz and Cathedral Park. But, yeah, we accompanied Diane Schur at the Mount Hood Festival of Jazz. We played with the Four Freshmen, Ernestine Anderson, Kurt Elling, Barbara Morrison, Ernie Andrews, and Bobby Shue. And, you know, this guy loves Kenton, so, you know, so he arranged to have Kenton's arranger, Pete Rugolo, come to town and put on a concert. So it's just been a major experience for me in my life, and I really do appreciate the opportunity that you gave me to play in this band. It's been awesome. So thank you, Art. So, lessons learned, okay? How to make it till 92, 93 years old? Always be looking for the next project. He still has another project in mind for next year, all right? And the other lesson is how he ends every one of his emails. Keep a song in your heart.
Change the mic somewhat. Can you hear me out there? First of all, why aren't you home listening to Jukebox Saturday night? Huh? Huh? What's all it's all about? No, I'm glad you're so happy you're here. This is the debut of a new band, a concept like Dave told you earlier, that really goes back to 10 years ago. I was not an Elvis fan, couldn't stand him. My wife took me to see a movie. And we walked out of that movie loving this guy. I believe, because he's saying, love me tender. And I said, there's more to this guy than just another rock star. And I followed his career, heard stuff he did, and I thought, and I hear so many copycat bands with imitation. Some are great, some are not. Some are not an insult to him. But I've never heard a band that plays a little concert, a little swing, a little R&B, still with a rhythm section that keeps the Elvis feel. And so we talked about it. A number of years went by. One thing went to another. The swing machine started working a lot. Couldn't get into it. And then who would I pick for it? David, which is completely out of his comfort zone. And as you see what he did tonight, all the charts, except for the one that just started this next set, which was written by Tom Malone, arranged by Tom Malone, Dave Parker did all the charts, all the charts. And no small task, so he has a beautiful wife, which is an orchestra wife, Cindy. To be married to a musician is a thing on its own. And, you know, all these guys, married or not, have had support behind them, be able to do this kind of thing. I certainly did. We gave up building a house to support a band. And I've got a great wife in Yvonne who's been there every step of the way. Although their name is on the program, I have the honor of introducing these fantastic musicians. Oregon, Washington is full of great musicians. I've got at least 16 of them right here in this band. So I want to introduce them to you so you can see who they are. And you've heard their fabulous playing tonight. Okay, let's start with the trumpet section. Garner, if you hold your applause till I end the section, after each section, please applaud and give them all your thanks for tonight. Garner Pruitt on trumpet, Greg Garrett, our lead man, the high note man, and Buzz Graham. Trumpet. on the trombone section, Jim Fitzpatrick, Rick Tibbetts, and John Onstad on bass trombone. And a great reed section. On the lead tenor, Jeff Holman, lead alto, Carl Poole, alto man and tenor man doubling, Dan Nelson, and on the baritone sax, and it's hard to get a great baritone sax player, Pete Boulay. Well, having great musicians mean nothing if you don't have a great rhythm section, and one that can cook and lay back when it has to. I don't know where to start because they're all, you know, I don't know. I'm going to start from the piano and work down. A guy that I latched onto some time ago, we used him as a sub in the Swing Machine, and I just couldn't do without him, Clay Giberson on the keyboard. On the bass, picked for this band, who's subs in the Swing Machine too. But I knew he could do this without even thinking. Dennis Callada on guitar, on bass. Working the electric bass here, but he plays a mad stand-up bass also. On the drums, I have to say, besides Dave Parker, my right arm in the music bands we have. My man, and he is my man. I tell you, love this guy.
25 years?
I'm trying to think of something else to say. But I can't, I just said all the words. Mike Snyder. Very special. And lucky to have a guitar player. I think you all know this gentleman. I can actually say this because I knew him when I came to town. He's a legend in his own time. Dan Bomber on guitar. You know, I'm proud to stand up. I don't do anything. My claim to fame is I pick the right guys for the right things. And I'm proud of that. And then you have two fabulous singers, as you heard tonight, singing with us for the first time. And Dave left out a lot of things. There was a lot of work behind the scene. And I want to throw another tribute to two guys. You've met them. But this night wouldn't have happened if it wasn't for Dave Parker and Rick Tibbetts. So I'd like to turn things back to educator, composer, trombonist, arranger, band leader.
Outstanding fisherman. Outstanding fisherman.
You know, he's an outstanding fisherman, but there's been many, and he has his fisherman friends in the audience tonight, I understand also. But there are times that we've come back and I've said, what kind of day is it? You know, Art, they weren't biting tonight. So I said, go ahead and write an arrangement, you'll feel better. Anyway, Mr. Dave Parker, thank you for being here, everybody. Thank you.
So how many 92-year-old people do you know that want to start a brand new band? There's only one. So all of these players are such great soloists. I tried to write so that everybody had a solo in this program. And I should be introducing their names as we go through, but they're in your program. Just all of these guys here, would you just give them a big hand? They are so amazing.
Thank you.
in a hurry.
This is one of the, I think this song was recorded and was put on the Blue Hawaii album. As my dad from Oklahoma would say, album. That's what they call it. So, the Blue Hawaii album. All right. For the lovers.
Wise men but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I say, would it be? Oh,
Don't you love that arrangement? Woo! The man in the blue suede shoes, the blue sparkly shoes. Yeah, you're gonna have to give them up. Put you in the mood a little bit. Well, I never been to Spain, but I kinda like the music. They say the ladies are insane there, and they sure know how to use it. They don't abuse it, they're never gonna lose it. Refuse it. See, I never been to England, but I kinda like the Beatles. I was headed for Las Vegas. I only made it out to Needles. Feel it. I said it feels so good now. Thank you. actually was born in Oklahoma. Y'all know that, right? I was born in Oklahoma, not Arizona. All right.
Yeah, we'll see you in church tomorrow morning, I'm sure. So Elvis won 3 Grammys, all for gospel tunes. 2 of the 3 Grammys were for this tune, How Great Thou Art. So I threw in a little bit of blood, sweat, and tears in it just to, you know. So here is How Great Thou Art.
Yes, yes.
Oh,